the production of many of the products that we use every day around the world in excess is emitting greenhouse gases. What if instead those same products are made from greenhouse gases? That's the idea that we're really thrilled about.
Petrochemicals are absolutely everywhere. We use them to package our food. They are woven into our clothes. They're parts of our homes. And they're even inside of our personal care products, such as lotions.
The environmental consequences of this are quite extensive. One in the form of damaging greenhouse gas emissions, and two in the case of plastics, their lack of degradation in the environment. So the most common compostable bioplastic is called PLA. It's made from plants, so that's competing with food for arable land. It's industrially polymerized, so the carbon footprint of its synthesis is actually not that much better than petrochemical plastics. And third, the term compostable is misleading in that it requires specific industrial composters to degrade it. And so what ends up happening is many of these materials just wind up in the landfill and there's no composting happening there. What we've been able to do so far with this project is to genetically engineer specific kinds of microbes that can eat CO2 and hydrogen gas and produce a kind of polymer that is biodegradable in the environment. The advantages here are twofold in that, one, we are using the same greenhouse gases that are being emitted by the petrochemical industry as building blocks for our material. And secondly, because these polymers can biodegrade in the environment, meaning they end up in the ocean, they will biodegrade, then we're able to contribute to offsetting the amount of pollution in our environment.
Our simple approach involves a carbon harvester installed at a CO2 or methane emission source, and the carbon is combined with hydrogen, also produced on site, to feed the microbes. After being cultured, the microbes are processed and the polymer is purified into a dry material that can be shipped, stored, and used to make products that are currently derived from fossil fuels. This form of PHA is non-toxic and readily degrades in the oceans and on land, and has superior material properties than existing PHAs. Our vision for the CISI system is to be highly modular in two ways. The carbon harvesters can be easily installed at existing factories that emit greenhouse gases, creating a supply chain that is resilient to market forces, and manufacturers can simply use our biodegradable polymers as their starting material rather than the petrochemicals they currently source.
Working with Marika is like working with a better version of myself. We share a lot of technical background and expertise, but as the project has progressed, we've actually been able to divide our labor to our various specialties.
Shannon is a night owl and I'm an early bird, so we found that between the two of us, we could work 24 hours.
So she's focusing much more on the genetic engineering and techno-economic analysis, whereas I'm working on the material science and fermentation technology.
Both of these form the core knowledge that is needed to bring the CISI project to reality.
Our vision for the project and the company is really to change how we do manufacturing at a global scale.
We're wondering, what if we could stop seeing greenhouse gases as a waste and rather use them as a resource?
We think that biology needs to be more involved, and particularly the use of gases as feedstocks so as not to compete with food for valuable land in a warming world.